Right, because we talk about lactose, so we also talk a little bit about lactose intolerance. What is lactose intolerance? In means like not acceptable. Tolerance is acceptable. Kind of chịu được. Tiếng Việt nó gọi là chịu được. Còn in là thành không chịu được. Ok. Không chịu được đường lactose. Bất dung nạp đường lacto. Ok, đó là cái định nghĩa về mặt tiếng Việt. What is lacto intolerant? This occurred quite a lot, not only rare situation. This is because the shortage of lactase enzyme. Lactase is the enzyme that hydrolyzes lactose. The scientific name is beta galactosidase. This enzyme will hydrolyze lactose into glucose and galactose, and then the simple sugar can be then absorbed into the blood through the small intestine wall into the blood. Okay. So what happened then? For example, a lot of people from Africa and Asia. A lot of people from this region have lactose intolerant. Why? Because people in this area do not have a history of consuming milk and dairy products. Infant, normally infant or baby, have this enzyme. If they don't have this enzyme, they cannot take milk from their mother. Because they can take milk from their mother, so they should have this enzyme to hydrolyze the lactose in the mother milk. But because in Asia, in Africa, then after the childhood period of life, people don't drink or don't eat dairy product anymore for a long time, and then the body will not produce this enzyme anymore because this enzyme has no function. So either the body will not produce or the body produce the enzyme but the activity of the enzyme is too low. So it cannot hydrolyze lactose anymore. So now at this person, if he take the milk inside the body, the enzyme either is too low or the activity is too low, cannot digest the lactose. When cannot digest the lactose, then the lactose will go to the large intestine. Normally, lactose is hydrolyzed in small intestine, but now it cannot be hydrolyzed, cannot be absorbed, so it will go to the large intestine. What do we have here? For example, I will just draw here a little bit so you see. This is the esophagus and this is the stomach. And then we have small intestine. And then we have large intestine. And the anus here, the colon and the anus. This is the more or less the gastrointestinal tract system of human. Now, normally lactose here is hydrolyzed from here and is absorbed into the wall, into the blood. But now, it cannot be hydrolyzed, so it's moved down to the large intestine. And in the large intestine, there is so many kind of microorganism there, bacteria there. They start to use lactose. They are happy with simple sugar, with simple carbohydrate. They use, they digest the lactose. They produce some gas, some certain kind of gas. Then the gas can move up here and then you birth out some gas, or because your body cannot digest the lactose, so some signal, the brain will give some signal for the muscle surrounding here to move the bowel, to move the content in the gut, will move faster down, to move out or say like that. So some people have severe lactose intolerance. After taking some herb of milk, they have to rush to the toilet to just to remove out because the body sense that it's not suitable. Okay. Now we go back to the question here. Why African and Asian people have this more often than the European people, because in Europe, people use milk and dairy products for whole life. They just take, they consume it whole time, so the enzyme will be synthesized and will work all the time. I have another question. Can we recover this situation? Normally, you can recover. Because after a long time, our body do not have this enzyme. But now, if you start to take milk again, little by little a day, and then you can increase the volume time to time, and then your body is okay. It can produce this enzyme and can hydrolyze milk normally. So you can actually recover if you have this or your parents have this. Normally, the old people have this more than young people, because they don't consume milk and dairy for a long time. And the third question, which product then suitable for the people who have lacto intolerance? In the market, they already sell milk with low lacto content. There are some products already in the market for the people who can buy this. Or you think of ripened cheese, you remember? Ripened cheese have low lacto. Or you can use yogurt. Yogurt is also more suitable for people of lacto intolerant than liquid milk. Why yogurt is more suitable? Because yogurts have lower level of lacto. 20% lower, if you remember. Okay? And because yogurts have still alive lactic acid bacteria. These bacteria, if they go into the large intestine you intake, if they can survive still there, then they can somehow have the digestion in a good way. And then the third reason is because yogurt is not liquid, but it is a gel already, a network. Okay. Because what? Because yogurt has a three-dimensional network already, because it's coagulate already during the making, so the lacto or the whey is trapped inside this network. When you eat inside, because they are trapped inside, so lacto is released slowly down, not so fast down, but slowly. So there is time for the weak enzyme to hydrolyze or the good bacteria to digest in a good way. But if you drink liquid milk, if you drink liquid milk, you drink inside and the pH in the stomach is very low. Remember, the stomach condition is very acidic. The pH is very low, so the coagulation occur here. The precipitation occur here. Low pH will precipitate the milk. When the milk is precipitated or coagulated, it's contract and it's released a lot of waste. A lot of lacto will go down so fast. And then the issue of gas formation and so on will be more severe. Okay, so in case if you have this or your parents have this, you can recover it time to time.